Hi guys, it's me, JJ. Welcome back to the Ratchet Diaries. I'm coming at you live with a brand new camera, so I have no fucking excuse not to make videos anymore. I know it's been a very long time since I made a video. It was like fucking December, like right after I started my job at the Lucky Horseshoe. So without further ado, let's get fucking started. Right before New Year's Eve, I met my current boyfriend, Mark. We met at the shoe. Our first date, we watched all 13 videos of the Ratchet Diaries. So I was scared to like move things forward. So that's why I was so excited to watch the Ratchet Diaries with him, because I wanted him to get to know like me as a whole. And so yeah, he watched every single one, 13 in a row, every single one in order. And yeah, so we've been basically dating ever since. And basically since January, we went on a date once a week and started getting to know each other more. And I just feel so lucky that he's my first relationship, and I couldn't be happier. And starting off a few weeks in January, I got on Chicago's Grab magazine.
Well, this is Grab magazine, Chicago's bi-weekly LGBTQ. And we got Drag Race, but there's me. I'm featured in a magazine, bitches. And I love all these guys very, very much, but I'm sorry, but I was serving it, honey. Yes, queen. Come through.
Starting in February, Mark asked me to plan a vacation with him after about a month and a half of dating. Basically, long story short, we're going to Paris next week. I'm so excited. It's been a dream of mine to go there for so long, and I never thought I'd get the opportunity this young in my life. So I'm so excited about that. I'm going next week, so that's the major thing. A week from today, actually, is my official birthday, and we will be in Paris. Bonjour, bitches. Are you ready for a fucking JJ? Okay. So after we decided we were gonna go to Paris for our vacation, I started the process of getting my passport. And so on Valentine's Day, Mark took me to file everything for my passport. And then at the end of February, my dad came to visit, and it was so much fun. He got to meet Iris for the first time.
Guys, guess who's finally in Chicago with me? Hi, Dad.
Hello.
We're watching Drag Race, getting him caught up because we're going to go to the viewing party tomorrow. So, yeah, I'm super excited. Love my dad.
At the end of March, I got to meet my favorite drag queen. One of my favorites, actually. Willem is my favorite. I met Adore Delano, and I've been wanting to meet her for so long. And then in April, my mom came to visit.
How was your time in Chicago?
Oh my gosh, we had a great time. It was so much fun. I love being with my JJ. I met Iris, but it was a great time. I need to go.
Mom's leaving today. Next time she'll see me, I'll be in New York. Love you, Mom. Love you so much.
Love you too.
Then in the middle of April, I ended up moving out of Iris's apartment because me and Mark were getting very close at that point. And we know this is only temporary because, newsflash, this is also a new thing. I'm planning on moving to New York at the end of the year. So, yeah, I just wanted to take advantage of the time that we have. Then starting off May, we celebrated Iris's birthday. So that was super fun. We ate at the Cheesecake Factory.
Happy birthday, Iris May. Happy birthday. Cheers. At the Cheesecake. Oh, yeah.
Happy birthday. I bought her her new human hair wig, and so we traded out, and since I bought her a blonde human hair wig, she finally gave me this one. This one is mine now, this human hair, darling. I got to meet Aquaria, the winner of RuPaul's Drag Race Season 10, as well as Monet Exchange and Pangina Heels. That was amazing as well. I've been following Aquaria for so long. And then starting off June 9th, we celebrated Mark's birthday. So I took him out to eat at the Lakefront Restaurant. We went and saw Ocean's 8, which was such a good movie. And then for his present, I got him 2 king-size Ralph Lauren pillows with matching navy blue pillowcases. So his birthday was very special. And then in the middle of June, me and Iris went and saw the Cher show.
At the Cher show.
It's Cher, bitch.
This is so beautiful.
The 3 women that played her, I couldn't believe how much their voices sounded like her. It was insane. End of June, we had Chicago's Pride Parade. And bitch, she wasn't watching the parade. She was in the parade, and it was such a magical, like, wonderful experience. And I just started tearing up just like being in the crowd, because everybody was just screaming their head off and they loved my outfit and loved what I look like. And I just have never felt so much, you know, support and love from, you know, so many people.
Happy Pride, y'all, on the Bud Light flow, me and my Victoria's Secret angel.
It was just the best Pride I've ever had. So yeah, you guys, that was pretty much what has been going on the past few months of this year. 2018 has literally been the best year of my life. Like, I could not be happier. Mark has brought me such happiness and love for myself. Like, I've never, you know, experienced like a real relationship before. And you know, like I said, he's an older man, but I don't care. Like, people my age are so immature and so stupid, and all they care about is going out, so I just could not be happier. So he's been such a huge blessing in my life, and I just could not be happier. As well as that, I mean, he's taking me to fucking Paris for my birthday next week, and so, yeah, I mean, to wrap it up, you guys, favorite things of this year definitely would be obviously meeting Mark and being able to spend all of this time with such a beautiful and wonderful man who accepts all of me and loves me just the way I am. And as well as that, serving looks for Drag Race, bitch. All year, Drag Race has been going on basically since January up until last week. And it's just, I was so happy to, like, you know, do that. I've been going to Roscoe's for the viewing parties for so long, and since basically season 8. And so one of the best things about going is I get to just serve looks. And so here is a whole montage of almost all of the looks. Yeah.
pretty queen, bitch. I love that drama. Fishy, feminine, up and comer. From the Clintons to the Obamas, I keeps it tight. Now they call, call, call.
In a world full of nines, be a ten. Season 10 queen, bring it to the runway. Bring it to the runway. Run back.
So yeah, you guys, that's pretty much my year so far. Next time you guys will see me, I will be in Paris. I'm definitely gonna be shooting all of that as much as I can. We're doing so much fun stuff, so I have to get all of that on film. And as well as that, yeah, I have no excuse not to make videos. I just invested in a really nice camera. I've been wanting to do that for a very long time. So I'm super excited now that I have a good camera and I can film and take really good pictures, an HD video. And yeah, the rest of the year from now on is really just working at my job that I absolutely love, the Lucky Horseshoe. You know, it was such a last resort kind of thing, and I didn't 100% want to be a stripper, but bitch, it is literally the funnest job ever. I get along with all of my coworkers. My manager is so sweet. This Saturday, he is doing Miley and Gaga, like, playlist, because every Saturday we do theme nights, and he's doing a theme night for me, created a poster for my birthday before I leave because it's my last shift. And I just love you, Rob. If you're watching this, I love you so much. And anyway, you guys, yeah, that pretty much sums it up. Until I see you next time, guys. Bonjour, merci, JJ est magnifique, yes, God. Thank you guys so much for watching. I'm sorry about my voice. I'm trying to get over this stupid cold. But yeah, you guys, I love you so much, and thank you for watching. Bye.